All right, so this morning in Destination Tuesday, we're delving into the vibrant world of Caribbean tourism with the Caribbean Hotel and Tourism Association. So here to tell us about their upcoming three-day event is President of the Caribbean Hotel and Tourism Association, Nicola Madden-Gregg. Good morning.
Good morning.
Welcome
How
to
are
Sunrise.
You?
Thank you. I'm happy
I
to be here.
Love these conversations
yes.
because travel is my middle name. Thank you. But I feel like people don't understand that although we live in this space, people long and crave, people desire so badly to come to Jamaica. So we mm-hmm. take it for granted, a
we
lot
do.
Of us who are
we
here.
Do.
So this association exists because this is a goal for a lot of people. What's
yeah.
the function of the association?
So the CHTA, the Caribbean Hotel and Tourism Association, we really promote destination, the Caribbean,
yeah.
and we have 33 member countries, and we of course work with all the hotels, the attractions, everything else, and our ultimate goal is to make the Caribbean continue to be the number one warm weather destination throughout the world.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, that's our goal.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. You know, what I love the way, for instance, we have like the JHTA, but the other hotel and tourism associations
mm-hmm.
of the region work together.
Mm-hmm. Correct.
There are excellent strategic partnerships because
mm-hmm.
we know we're competitors but not really competitors because we do work together to build each other. Tell us about the marketplace and how that creates a synergy.
So marketplace, now we're in our 42nd year
mm.
and we haven't been to Jamaica since 2019, so this is great for me as president, a
mm-hmm.
Jamaican
yes.
president, to bring it back home.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
And it's actually going to be my last marketplace. I've done three in this presidency and I'm stepping down this year.
Yeah,
so.
Okay, all right.
So it's big for me. But what Marketplace does, it brings in all our international partners, so the big tour operators, travel advisors,
mm-hmm.
the media. We have over 50 media that will be attending. And we meet with all of the hoteliers, the suppliers to the industry, the attractions, the transportation providers, and we contract and we look about how can we really drive more business to the Caribbean. So
mm-hmm.
it's a three-day showcase. We have the first day, which would be our business of tourism, where
mm-hmm.
we have the travel forum, where all the regional international thought leaders will kind of get into how do we ensure that Caribbean tourism not only survives as we've come through COVID, but continues to thrive and
mm-hmm.
grow.
Mm-hmm.
You know, we have about 19 million persons living in the region, and we welcome somewhere in the region of 33 million persons to the Caribbean
wow.
each
mm-hmm.
year. And we're trying to grow that, you know, trying to get back to even better than our 2019 figures, and I think we'll do that this year.
Oh.
So it's a big push for us. The WTCC has said that we have the potential by 2032 to double our GDP from tourism, as well as provide another 1.34 million jobs. So this show is very important to ensure that we continue to grow in that direction.
I love that you ended on that point, because I was just going to ask you, for the person who maybe doesn't quite understand, how critically important is the tourism industry to our overall economic functioning?
Very.
I mean, it's our economic driver, and you know, we have to think about all the linkages that tourism really
right.
Attaches itself to. So we have manufacturing, we have agriculture, we have the creative space, you know, we have so many services that are supported by tourism. Of course, our airlines, of course, the airports, that the size that we have now wouldn't be what it is because most of our visitors are driving that business. So it's something that really permeates the economy in everything
mm-hmm.
in length and breadth. And now we're seeing more growth in smaller accommodations in terms of the shared economy, and that's
yes.
growing a lot. In Jamaica now, we're up to approximately 30% of the stopover arrivals going into that space. So it's very important that we recognize how tourism can drive us. You know, countries like Dubai have put it as their number one strategic
yes.
goal in terms
mm-hmm.
of growing their country, and they have oil. So
right.
we in the
and
Caribbean
desert.
Yeah, we need to
Meanwhile,
recognize
we have ocean. Right,
that
right.
this is something that we should capitalize on.
Yeah.
Entrepreneurs, young people should get into the space, because there's a lot to gain from it, and definitely it is our wheelhouse. We know how to do it. We know how to do it well. I was at the Chris Investment Conference a couple of weeks ago in Miami, and every single major chain in the world is trying to get a piece of the Caribbean and have
mm.
hotels here.
Mm-hmm.
So we have to really understand the big business that we're in.
Yeah. Tell us the when, where, and how of
So
the
we
conference.
Are May 20th to 23rd.
Mm-hmm.
We'll be in the Montego Bay Convention Center. And it's going to be 3 days of fun. And last but not least, because I think this is important, on the last day, which is Labor Day in Jamaica,
mm-hmm.
we'll be having our Responsible Tourism Day. First ever,
Whoa.
We're doing this. As well as we are doing a multi-destination FAM that is going to St. Lucia, Barbados, Jamaica and Cayman, and we're definitely promoting regional travel and how we can all partner to ensure that when you come to the Caribbean, you don't just say, well, I went to one destination and so I've been to the Caribbean. No, right. You haven't been to 5, 6, 7, 10, 15 places, you haven't quite been to the Caribbean yet. So
absolutely.
That's the plan. That's
I'll carry your bags.
Our guest, Nicola Madden Gregg, president of the Caribbean Hotel and Tourism Association. When we return, it's time for Sunrise Freshers. Don't move a muscle. We'll be right back.
I'ma get no be so, girl, you won't capture my soul. I'ma get no be so.